Well, we're done with today. That was very quick. And I took this car today. I thought I was gonna be okay today, and so far I am, so hopefully I get home.
So right here, 5 seconds ago, I just saw the first i3 on the road I've ever seen. BMW i3. That still looks like a crazy concept car. But I guess you can go to a dealership and buy one. That's crazy. That looks like something that is, it's just a concept for 10 years down the road. That is very interesting. So it's 12:01. That gives me 59 minutes before today's event starts in San Francisco. I really wish I were in San Francisco. It's probably a beautiful day. Maybe it's, I don't know, it's fall. It's 9 a.m. and it's fall. It could be like 50 and cloudy as hell right now. I don't know. It's hot in San Diego though. My dad's complaining about how hot it is down there. So anyways, I got math done. We're doing difference quotients, and I just fail to see any application to a difference quotient. For math majors, accountants, shit like that, sure. Come on, I'm in business management. I am not gonna need to do quadratic averages. And if I do, I'll hire an intern to do it. I hate math. So, yeah, i3 on the road, Apple event in an hour. I'm gonna go home, get something to eat. Then Kenan's coming over, and we're going to watch that. It'll be exciting. All the same cars. That is so much weight. An Anerka. Look at that. Uh-oh, it's the police. He's up here and I'm doing one under. In fact, I'm pretty sure I know where it is. They had a car stationed at Seton Catholic School with a, is that S5, S6? S6, or S4. Oh, Joe, you're gonna kill me. I can't tell them apart half the time when they're going by too fast. It's at Seton School on Stowe Road. There's nobody in it, at least there wasn't over an hour ago. They've got one of those, you're going so many miles an hour. So we'll see if we can get it to triple digits here in a minute. Yeah, that's what it is. Let's test the M5 speedometer versus radar. I'm gonna get it to exactly 35. That's gonna be hard to do in film. I know there's nobody in that car unless he's come out and is now sitting in there. So my speedometer, crap, that's hard to do with Cruise. Says 36. And that says 35, 34. That could have been the car behind me there. So that's pretty accurate. I don't know which one's off. Speedometers are usually off.
Hey, so it's now 1 o'clock. I'm pretty tired. So I'm gonna try to keep this quick. It'll probably still end up being a 5-minute clip. Come down here so I don't get yelled at for talking loudly at 1 in the morning. Anyways, today, new iPhones, new iWatch, Apple Watch. I'm gonna try not to call it an iWatch because Apple is not calling it an iWatch. It's the Apple Watch. You don't live under a rock, you're not Patrick Starr, you probably heard about it. If you don't like iPhones, that's fine. You're misinformed. I had to say it. No, but, you know, pretty much what we expected out of the 6 and the 6 Plus. Nothing crazy with that. I tried to watch the keynote live. That was the worst live streaming I've ever seen.
I originally, in the beginning, was really frustrated with my internet connection and with my browser, and the Apple TV was screwing up. I'm like, what is this crap? I can't even sit down and use my Apple technology when I want to. No, it's the streaming. Everybody across the world was having issues with streaming. It would play for 20 seconds and then totally cut out and access denied on the homepage. I tried to use the Apple TV thing that they made a little applet for that. That didn't work either. It was crap. It was just a miserable broadcast. Anyways, I did go back and watch the keynote. I was able to see everything that Tim and Phil and everybody talked about today. And as I said, pretty much as expected. iOS 8 doesn't even look like it's going to do much, but just bring features to the table for the 6 and 6 Plus. For those of you wondering, I'm going with a 128 gig 6 in space gray. So I'm excited for that, definitely. A bigger screen is welcome, but 5.5 inches to me is just going to turn into a phablet. It's about time we see a 128 gig option. I was hoping for that with the 5, the 5S, and now with the 6, it's finally here. Thank God. My 64 is totally full. I went through and deleted like half of my conversation history in the Messages app, and that freed up 2 gigs, but I need more space than that. So, that's what I'm going to do with that. The Apple Watch, there I go again. The Apple Watch looks intriguing. I loved how, ever since we lost Steve a few years ago, there's no more mention of the one more thing until today. They saved it for that, and that was really cool. That was a great throwback. And when Tim first started taking stage, it didn't feel the same. It didn't feel like Apple. And now it does. Maybe we've gotten used to it. He's a great speaker. He's a great presenter. Nobody's going to trump Steve, but it was a good presentation. Just the broadcasting sucked. So I'm excited for the pre-order. My phone's not eligible for upgrade. Grandparents' lines are. They have no plans of getting phones, so I'll just use their eligibility upgrade again, as I did with the 5 a few years ago. So I plan on pre-ordering Friday, taking delivery, I believe, the following Friday or Saturday or something like that. So that'll be exciting. What else was I going to say? I mowed across the street today. I did a power mow in fourth gear. It took like 40 minutes. It was fast. Didn't take off much grass. I'm trying to be super proactive with taking care of that as I pace in my basement. I'm sorry, I don't want to stand here. It's scuzzy down here. This is the nasty side of the basement. Battery light's flashing, so that's my cue to wrap things up. Leave some comments. What do you think about the event today? What iPhone are you planning on getting? For those people that are comparing the new 6 Plus to like the LG something 3 and the big Note 4 and doing all these spec comparisons, it isn't your hardware, it's how you use it. And as somebody famous in Apple said a long time ago, people that are serious about making software make their own hardware. And that's how I'm going to leave things off tonight. You can put an octa-core processor that has 12 gigahertz and a terabyte of RAM in a machine, and it's still gonna suck dick if the software does. And that's where Android is. All right, start giving me shit. I hate Android, I hate Windows Phone. I just don't see them as usable platforms. Maybe I haven't spent enough time with them. Maybe I'm short-sighted. All right, I'm going to bed. So we'll talk tomorrow on Wednesday. Getting stuff done. I'm trying to get a haircut tomorrow and do another yard. All right, good night.